Hi guys, recently we were invited to the Bessie May Women's Center in East Orange, New Jersey to see our friend Asia D. Smith receive an award from Mary Pat Christie. She is the wife of our governor, Governor Christie, and she received the award called the New Jersey Heroes Award. So let's take a look at that presentation.
To talk to you guys and get your perspective on what happens here and how amazing Asia is. And actually, Asia, I know a lot about your story, but for posterity's sake, I'd love to hear a quick summary of it.
Sure. Well, unfortunately, I found myself the victim survivor of domestic violence a few years ago. And it started out reading a couple of articles, and people would say really mean things about victims and survivors. You know, they're weak, they're stupid, they ask for it. So I started out writing rebuttals, and I just wanted to kind of hide in the corner and just say a little something about it. But fortunately, the articles actually took on a life of their own. And we had several people say, wait a minute, I'm a victim survivor as well, and that's not true for me. And then we started having support groups, and we would have support groups in the library and in any space that we could find.
And support groups really, I mean, support groups didn't really exist or just...
Well, you know what, they're very minimal. And also, you know, to find support groups in the community, and that was also very difficult because we would think about with the millions of victim survivors, there aren't as many resources as there should be.
Sure.
And so when you're looking for stuff like that, I wanted to just make it as seamless as possible because I knew the challenges that I had. And I had resources, I had transportation, but then I had to think about what about the other individuals that may not have those same resources.
So I got a chance to learn about what goes on here, and it was really quite remarkable. So I want to thank those women that were willing to tell me their stories and share what they've gone through in the past. To kind of educate me. But anyway, so here we are at our first awarding of a New Jersey Hero this year. You might be saying it's March 26th, Mary Pat, why so long? But I got preoccupied with something called Hurricane Sandy.
Yes.
But I think it's a really great opportunity for us to acknowledge somebody during the month of March, which happens to be Women's History Month.
Yes.
We're acknowledging and honoring a woman who has been really just tremendous in her founding of RAIN and her empowerment of other women. So Asia has done remarkable things for not only the women she's helped, but the broader community. And I see a lot of heads shaking up and down. But, you know, domestic violence is something that affects all of us, whether we realize it or not, and it affects the fabric of our community. And one of the things we were just speaking about was how we can be such good examples for our children and to try to stop that cycle, which is what Asia and her team are doing. You know, some of the people, I don't know if Len's still here, but Len and her other colleague told me that one of the things that, I mean, Len, I think, is getting ready to get a graduate degree she's hoping to go to law school and to promote what her examples have been. And then we also have a client, is it What's her first name? Shireen, where'd you go?
They didn't.
Okay. Well, anyway, this woman, I have to tell you, she has survived domestic violence and is now starting a program to go out to the schools and tell her story. And Shireen really was touched my heart. Anyway, all of those things are happening because of Asia, who's been willing to put herself out there and start this great community. So as a result, we give you a lovely little pin that says that she's a New Jersey hero. Do you mind if I pass this on? One of 19 people that have gotten this award, and one of the things I was telling her is that we really encourage our heroes to network with one another, mm-hmm. share best practices and ideas, mm-hmm. and it really has become a nice little group who really depend on one another, and we have all sorts of programs going on to help them. We have a lovely little basket that has little things for her, you know, including a lovely picture of my husband and me. It's really fun Thank stuff. You. And then, of course, the big surprise, and I don't know if this is a surprise to Asia, but we're lucky enough to be able to award Asia and Rain $7,500. And help promote the great things you guys do here. And that's really it. So there's a whole grant program we have now where we let the current New Jersey heroes apply for grants. So it really makes a difference to be a New Jersey hero. She's overwhelmed. I love when I get my heroes to cry.
And I never cry. I mean, we talk about some really sad things all the time, but this is like so overwhelming. First, I just want to thank you for selecting our organization, for coming all the way here to just honor us and grace the center with your presence. Secondly, I want to thank all of the women who have been a part of this from the very beginning. And you guys really helped me a lot in just staying grounded. Then to all of the folks here in the room that have really supported and just believed in Purple Rain from the very beginning, that means so much. And we're going to continue to spread our message of empowerment, but most importantly, to eradicate domestic and sexual violence in our communities and in the world, is really what we want to do. So thank you so much.
One of the things that the First Lady of Massachusetts, Diane Patrick, has actually taken domestic violence up as one of her initiatives. And when we meet as governor's wives, this is one of the things that we talk about. So rest assured, this is actually happening in some other states. I'm sure it's not happening as well as we do, but there are, across the country, because you say we want to eradicate it across the country.
Yes, exactly.
And, it's something that people are aware of. We have to keep telling the story.
And we look forward to joining you and helping, you know, to develop policies and initiatives that will really be in effect that will change the way we look at relationships and violence in our communities. So we thank you for that. Thank you so much. There's a few people in the room, if I may.
Yeah, please.
Senator Gill, would you mind coming forward? Yay. Mayor Bowser is here.
Oh, you're in the back.
Thank you.
County exec.
I heard the county executive was here earlier. Whenever I'm in Essex County, Joe D shows up. He had to sneak out, I guess.
But we have Pam McCauley here from the Essex County Prosecutor's Office. We've got Rose Williams from the New Jersey Coalition for Battered Women here.
Janine LaRue and Miss Janine LaRue.
Say thank you to everyone that's here. You're not forgotten at all. So I just wanted to just acknowledge everyone and thank you all for being here to share this amazing honor with me. So I appreciate you all for coming out today.
I think it's a first off to the First Lady, to our recipient, and to this community. This is wonderful. And as women, we know that we will have to reach out to other women. We need to protect our sisters. We need to provide that comfort and that level of security, and we need to empower women to know that if you educate a woman, you educate a nation. And I think it is wonderful that the First Lady is here. You know, that's absolutely great. Underscores the commitment to our fight with respect to domestic violence and to be in the community in this space that's both loving, warm, efficient, effective, and empowering. So thank you.
Amen.
So much.
Okay. Hi, everybody. We're with the First Lady of New Jersey, Mary Pat Christie. How are you?
Great.
Now, what is the New Jersey Hero program all about?
So New Jersey Heroes is a program we started 3 years ago so that we could recognize ordinary New Jerseyans that were really doing extraordinary things, mostly on their own time from a nonprofit standpoint.
You know, New Jersey is very progressive in different programs for battered women and people suffering with alcohol and drug abuse. So, you know, we're very proud of that, of what our governor is doing in office, right?
I think so. This is just another way to recognize people that are really making a difference. And Asia, as the person that really founded Purple Rain, has touched so many women that find themselves in domestic violence situations and really has enabled them to speak about their stories in a way that when I had a round table with some of the victims, they've said they never had an opportunity to do that before. So she really is a standout amongst people that are doing this work. And she makes a point of saying that there are really great programs out there. But this is just something that seems to really empower the women that come here.
Now, people apply for this program, New Jersey Heroes. They send in applications to the state?
Yes, we have a website, and anybody can nominate their heroes. In fact, I encourage people to nominate their heroes. And we have heroes in all sorts of walks of life. So, you know, March happened to be Women's History Month, so I think it was a great month to be able to advocate for women and honor a woman. But we have tremendous heroes in all sorts of different categories, so to speak. People that are really making a difference in all sorts of ways.
Great. Thank you for being here on Inside.
You bet.
Thank you.
Take care.
Hi. How are you?
I'm doing well.
Now tell us, you know, what is your role here at Purple Rain?
Well, I am the president and CEO of the Bessie May Women's Health Center, where we're standing. And Purple Rain is one of the programs that we run and offer to our patients in the community here. Asia D. Smith, who received that wonderful award today, the Hero Award, we nominated her because we knew that she was the epitome of success, as well as she manages the program here. She runs it, directed. She's the founder, of course, of Purple Rain, and the service that she's offering to the patients that come in the door here and to the community are just phenomenal. She does one-on-one counseling as well as group sessions, and she's doing an absolutely fantastic job here. Right here, we offer primary care services, OBGYN for women. We also offer chiropractic services, mental health services, and we have several different free programs for the community, colorectal testing, breast and cervical testing and screening, as well as STD testing. It's free, and pregnancy testing for the community. We also have a weight management program as well as a career and development program. We do life coaching here, but one of the largest programs here is the domestic violence sexual assault advocacy program. And so today I just want to say how proud I am of Asia, and she is the perfect person to receive such an award, being a person who have overcome that situation in her life and being bold enough to just share with other women and to help them through the transition in their lives. It's just wonderful.
Now, does a woman have to be a survivor of domestic violence to take advantage of what you guys have here to offer?
Absolutely, absolutely not. Again, this is the Bessie May Women's Health Center, and if anyone would like to see any of the doctors, they can call for an appointment or they can walk in. We accept patients that are insured or uninsured. We accept almost all of the different HMOs and insurances, Medicaid, Medicare, as well as we have self-pay patients. patients, people who don't have a lot of money, we have a sliding fee scale. We'll work with them. We don't let anyone walk out the door that needs medical care. While they're here, sometimes the doctors realize that they need additional help, whether it's pastoral care counseling or whether it's domestic violence counseling for challenges that they're going through in their life, whether it's weight management. We have parenting and co-parenting workshops. We have cancer survivor group sessions here. We have over 12 different programs. This is a medical home, but it's a one-stop shop. So when people come here, we are here to help them on their journey to better health.
Now, what's that number that people can call to get in touch with you guys here?
You can call 973-766-1303. And how we came up with the name Bessie, it's my grandmother who lived to be 103. She had 11 children, outlived two husbands, and she never had a driver's license. She walked everywhere. But she, when she passed this life, she passed from natural causes. She was an extremely healthy woman who took care of herself. So we thought, who else to name the health center after than a woman such as she? I want her legacy to live on. And I want other women to hear her story. So I always say that it's important that we see our doctors. It's important that we take care of ourselves. It's important that we manage our health. And we, the Bessie Mae Women's Health Center, and our partners, Purple Rain, and the other partners that we have, we're here for the community. And that's exactly what we're doing.
Wow, you guys are doing a great job. Thank you very much for existing in the community.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Hi, everybody. We are here with our favorite guest, Miss Asia D. Smith. Hey, Asia, how are you?
Thank you, Valerie. I am elated. I feel like I'm floating right now.
Now, congratulations on you winning this award.
Oh, thank you so very much. I am just so humbled and just honored to have our First Lady come here, you know, to recognize the work that we're doing in the community, but more importantly, to really just to inspire other people in the community to believe and to dare to dream that you can make a huge difference in the community. So yes.
Mm-hmm. Now, let's say for people that have maybe been living under a rock for like the last year or so, Asia, she's a champion for survivors of domestic violence. And this whole center is really dedicated to all women in general, but specifically women that are survivors of domestic violence.
Yes. Domestic violence and sexual assault are two components that we have here. It's really important to have resources in the community. You know, it's devastating when you find yourself in that position, but it's really worse when you don't have, you know, the places to go to seek the help that it is that you need. So we wanted to eliminate some of the barriers. I mean, while we cannot control what happened in their relationships, we can certainly control, you know, how they're receiving information and then the resources going forward. So we really just try to at least be that light in the community for victim survivors.
Now, you win a lot of awards, but this one is huge from the governor's office, right?
Yes, this is an honor, you know, that I can't even put into words. I am just so, you know, just, I feel on top of the moon, like I really do. And to have her to come to this community, it shows that it's not about politics. It's not about parties. It's not about personalities. It's about people doing extraordinary things. And so I'm just really just honored as a New Jerseyan to stand here, but more importantly, as someone from the community to stand here and just let people see that this can happen. And so we're just so, so honored to receive this award.
Great. Now, what do you guys have coming down the pike? I know you have some things you're probably working on.
Yes, we have quite a few things that we're working on. We were blessed to receive an awesome, awesome property that we're looking to open up as one of the first of many safe havens worldwide. It's going to be a holistic therapeutic facility. So victim survivors can come and just receive all of the resources that they need, but more importantly, the healing that's necessary to move forward after being a victim and survivor of domestic violence and sexual assault.
So again, thank you, Asia. Wow, congratulations for being here on Inside, and congratulations on winning your award. Yes. So, you know, we can say that we knew her first, right?
Yes, yes. In fact, I just want to thank you and then the work that you guys are doing, because you've been featuring Purple Rain for a number of years now. You believed in our organization when we were just on the ground. And so that is inspiring within and of itself. And so the work that you're doing, the platform that you're using to educate people about the services and the resources, but more importantly, how to move forward is really key. And so I just thank you for that. So thank you so much.
Well, thank you for inviting us. You know, you are not just a guest, you're family at Inside, right?
Yes.
Well, congratulations again.
Oh, thank you, Valerie.
And there you have it, our winner for a New Jersey Hero Award from the governor's office, Miss Asia D. Smith. Hi, we are here with Playtyme, Miss Lisa. How are you, Lisa?
I'm doing well. How are you, Valerie?
Great. Now, I met this group or this organization at the Child Abuse Conference, and I had such a good time. Didn't I have a good time?
Yes.
I had a really good time. So I said, you know, we got to bring them into the studio, and you guys donated your time to that event, correct?
Yes, we do. We definitely believe in giving back.
Now, talk about Playtyme. What is Playtyme?
Well, it's Playtyme. We're a mobile game show company, and we're, you know, located in central New Jersey. And when I was growing up, I watched so many game shows. I love game shows, and my favorite was Family Feud. Mm. And I tell people all the time that I grew old, but I never grew up. So I love playing games, and I love game shows. So I decided to, you know what? You have to go through so much to get on a game show. How about if I provide that for the public? How about if I go out and I have a company, whereas I can come to you, and you can be on a game show, and we can give prizes and have fun, and it could be anything you want. It could be fun, scholastic, or just anything. And I just love it, and I want the community to feel what I felt as a child.
Now, you guys not only do Family Feud, you also do Wheel of Fortune, and what other game shows?
We do the Wheel of Fortune style, we do the Jeopardy style, and we do, like, just trivia, which is, like, Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, that kind of style as well.
Okay, great.
So we do those four, and then we do other interactive games. Whatever the client wants, we figure it out, and we give it to them.
And you guys have, like, packages of what you could do. You have, like, a three-piece jazz band. You know, it really depends on the event, right?
Mm-hmm, yes, it depends on the event and how big they want it. We're an entertainment company as well. We have DJs, we have live bands, we have comedians, you name it. We basically have access to all of that kind of entertainment.
Yeah. Wow. If you guys want more information about Playtyme, go to our website, and we have a link there where you can get in contact with them. Now, tell me about Family Feud. Is it usually children? Because there was children at the last event. Now you want children to play this one, although I wanted to play. But that's okay. We'll let the kids play.
Okay. Well, it was for adults. Because I feel that as we grow older, we stop having fun. And we lose that childlike in us. And I really want that to come back. See, look, like you wanted to play. That's what I want to do for adults. But guess what? The kids, you know, they take over.
Yes, they do.
And that's what happened.
They do.
So when they saw it, I'm like, oh, this is adorable. I've never seen a kid's version of Family Feud.
Right.
So that's why that's been very, very popular.
Okay.
But we do it for all ages, even seniors.
Wow.
So, yeah, it's. I just want to bring that laughter, and I want to bring the fun back to the community.
That's wow. Really well, let's show them a little bit of that laughter. We're going to play a little bit for you guys to see, you know, how Lisa and her company does the Family Feud and the games at an event. Like, it could be a bridal shower, a wedding, a party,
we have
or whatever.
A graduation on June 1st. We have a graduation. We do all kind of different events, corporate events. When we did a baby shower, they were ready to feud. It's just a lot of fun. In any kind of event, barbecue, we set up outside.
Wow.
I mean, it's just, that's why we're mobile. We want to bring it to we bring it to you.
Bring the fun.
We bring the fun.
All right. So we're going to bring the fun to you. We're going to go to that segment right now.
Okay, we have the top 7 answers on the board, and here's the question. Name a household appliance. Come on, hit somebody. Your answer?
A stove.
A stove. Very good. Let's see if it's up there. All right. Number five. Very good. Your turn. Name a household appliance. A refrigerator? Let's see if refrigerator's up there. Survey says refrigerator. Okay. So now he's got the most popular answer. So I'm going to ask him, are you going to play or are you going to pass the question? Yeah, he's passing it. Yeah, that means you guys get to play, okay? All right? So, little one, name a household appliance.
A dishwasher.
Ah, dishwasher. She says dishwasher. Let's see if it's up there. Dishwasher. All right. Very good. And you, little one, let's see if you know the answer. Name a household appliance. Oh, she don't know. You don't know the answer. Okay. All right. Let's. Huh? You want to go for her? Okay. Name a household appliance.
A microwave.
A microwave. All right. Number one answer. Look, you guys got one, two, three. You got three answers left. Okay. Let me see if this little one here can give me another household appliance, if she could think of one. Oh, no. That's okay. So now we got three answers left. Okay. So let me see. You think of something. Okay. That the time is up. Okay. We're going to try to give the boys a little chance to play. All right. All right. Let's see. Name a household appliance.
A toaster.
Toaster. Is toaster on the board? Toaster's on the board. Okay. We got two answers left. What do you say? Household appliance. TV? Let's see if TV's on the board. Oh, no, it's not on the board. Okay, you try it. What's the next answer? Household appliance. Is it on the board? No, that's not on the board. Okay, we got one more.
Can I try?
You want to try it? Okay, what is it?
A sink.
Oh, no, a sink is not up there. You know what we're going to try to do? We're going to try to see what is left. What else is up there? Number six, a vacuum, a vacuum. Let's see it. Number seven, a blender. Very good, okay. So now you guys get to see is 100 points. But guess what? Since y'all tried, y'all both did very well. And we want to thank you guys for playing, okay? All right? Yeah? Okay. Thank you. Give them a round of applause for playing, y'all. Thank you, guys.